So now that we are familiar with training multilayer perceptrons, how can we make the training more efficient? One aspect is using data loaders, as we have just seen in the previous videos. And the other one is using GPUs, graphical processing units. So let's take a look at how that works. So if you remember, in Unit 2, we discussed what PyTorch is. So PyTorch is a tensor library, and it has an automatic differentiation engine. The third thing that PyTorch is, it's a deep learning library. So it implements a lot of convenience functions for deep learning, as we have just seen. And one nice thing about PyTorch is that the tensors in the tensor library support GPUs. So that's something that, for example, NumPy does not do. So one of the cool features of Torch Tensor is that we can easily transfer the tensor from CPU to GPU memory. And we can do that by using the to method by providing an argument CUDA here. So CUDA is a GPU computing library specifically for NVIDIA GPUs. So the key idea here is that we can load the data and the model into GPU memory, where we can then do the computations faster. So things like matrix multiplications and later the convolutions, they will be faster if we run them on GPUs compared to a regular CPU. However, in order to make this happen, we have a few requirements here. So first, we need a computer, either a local or a cloud computer, that has a GPU, of course. So right now, PyTorch supports NVIDIA GPUs, AMD GPUs, and also, if you have one, the Apple Silicon chips. So if your computer has a GPU and you want to use it, you would have to install the GPU version of PyTorch if you haven't done so yet. In order to install the right version for your computer, I recommend going to the PyTorch.org website and using this installation menu to find out which installation command you need for your operating system and your GPU. But yeah, how would you know whether your computer has, for example, an NVIDIA GPU? One way to find out is in the terminal by running NVIDIA SMI, which will show you all the graphics processing units on that computer. So here you can see an example of where I ran NVIDIA SMI on a computer that has 4 GPUs. So we mentioned that GPUs can accelerate the computation of, let's say, matrix multiplications. And we also briefly discussed how we can set up PyTorch for GPU computing. So the main reasons why GPUs are faster than CPUs for certain operations, like matrix multiplications, is that GPUs have, for example, more memory bandwidth. And GPUs, of course, also have more computing cores. So if we have computations like matrix multiplications that benefit from parallel processing, GPUs are usually better for that. So now, concretely, how do we load our data into GPU memory in PyTorch? So first, I recommend running the torch CUDA is available command to make sure that your current PyTorch session supports GPUs. If it returns true, all is good. However, if it returns false, your computer may not support GPUs, or your current PyTorch installation may not support GPUs. So now, assuming that your computer and your PyTorch session supports GPUs, we can then instantiate a tensor in PyTorch and transfer it to the GPU memory using .2 CUDA. And then, of course, we can also transfer it back to the CPU memory by calling to CPU. And yeah, this is all you need in PyTorch to transfer a tensor from CPU memory to GPU memory and back. So now, if we consider the model training loop that we discussed earlier, in order to make the model training happen on the GPU, there are only 3 little changes here that we have to make. So first, we have to transfer the model to the GPU. And then in each for loop, in each training iteration, we also then have to transfer the features and the class labels to the GPU as well. And that's really all we have to do to train a model on the GPU using PyTorch. Yeah, and if your computer does not have a GPU, don't worry about it. Most of the code examples in this course are also purposefully kept simple so that they can also run on a CPU. Also, there are many great GPU cloud resources available where you can just rent GPUs. That's usually also what I do, because I do most of my coding on a laptop. And of course, I will share a few GPU cloud resources with you in case you are curious and want to get started with GPU computing. And later on, when we get to Unit 7 or 8, I will also let you know which code examples require a GPU to run efficiently. So, in Unit 4, we covered multilayer perceptrons and we saw how data loaders work. We also covered GPUs in this video to make the training even more efficient. Now, we should be pretty familiar with PyTorch and how it works and how we can train multilayer neural networks. So in the next unit, we are going to cover Lightning, which helps us organize our PyTorch code. We will then also use Lightning to add a few more advanced features to get, let's say, more performance out of our neural networks.